Back in 1974, after my sister was killed, and I had all this pain. I was a teenager, I didn't know what to do with it. Then later on, after I had my accident, and I was left paralyzed and going through a lot of physical and emotional pain because I didn't know, you know, what was going to become of my life. Every time I needed hope, every time I needed to get outside of that dark place that I was going in, or every time I felt like I was headed there, I could find that something to hold on to. I knew there was a clinic right there in my neighborhood that I could go to get help. It actually helped take some of the scary away. I know that I have a depression problem, but I know how to get help, and I know where to go and get it. But if that option is taken away from me, just the thought is scaring me to death. I don't know what I would do with all that pain that I have inside of me. You know?
I lost a son in November 26th of 2006, and without the clinic, I would be dead right now. I was on the phone with my son when he was getting shot. My little one had his brother in his arm. My little one got shot in the kneecap, and my oldest one got shot in the neck, and he died in his arm. I just finally got my son out of the house for him to get help for therapy. So we cannot close this clinic because now my son comes on his own and he is getting help now. And if without the clinic, you know, I will not be here today.
I was shot in the head 20 years ago driving my car. And I'm a person with post-traumatic stress disorder and I need help to deal with my illness every day. It serves me through, help me get through, help me to live day by day and keep my sanity in order.
Porque yo nací así. Yo nací así, pero con la medicina me controlo. Pero como ahora que se va a cerrar, va a haber mucho problema y demasiados problemas grandes. Esto porque la enfermedad de la esquizofrenia es una enfermedad que tiene cura, pero siempre cuando uno sepa el tratamiento que le dan uno aquí.
I was about to jump out the third floor window and kill myself, but I didn't like myself and I didn't love myself. But since I come around here, I've been around people that helps me to learn to love myself. I feel more secured about myself, and I feel that if they take a lot of people from this clinic here and send them somewhere else, things is gonna get worse.
The people who need their help is important. For the community itself, it's important. It helps to stabilize the neighborhood. I think without it, people have said without it, the crime rate would go up. Several months ago, the ceiling collapsed, so they were forced to evacuate for about 5 months while the ceiling was being fixed. During that time, people were forced to go to the River North Center, Peterson, Pulaski. During the time that they had to go out there, they ended up losing half their clients.
What I can see happening is people are not going to go to get treatment because they don't want to go anywhere else. And that's going to end up causing more money to be spent for hospitals, for police.
What I've been experiencing was happening ever since I was young. You know, I was always talking to somebody, wasn't there, invisible, because I felt like I didn't have no outlets, no escape. I didn't feel like I had somebody that could relate to me. Going to Beverly Morgan Park has helped me because that's therapy within itself. If they close down Beverly Morgan Park Clinic and any other clinics to follow, you know, if they think they, you know, they having a problem now and they singing the blues now, it's going to be a whole lot of blues now. They're going to be singing even more because these are services and programs we desperately need. And not just me, but we all do.
Yo fui víctima de violencia criminal. Me golpearon, pero los hombres que me golpearon, ellos pensaron que yo estaba muerta. Desde esa fecha yo agarré una depresión muy grande porque me quedé con muchos ataques de pánico, ataques de terror, y tuve que venir al hospital psiquiátrico por 3 meses. Al salir del hospital, a Dios gracias, me dieron la ayuda en la clínica y hasta el momento me han ayudado mucho porque he superado mucho ese terror tan grande que yo tenía. Entonces ahorita yo me pongo a pensar, si cierran la clínica, ¿qué va a ser de nosotros que tenemos la clínica tan cerca ya que no tenemos transportación? Yo al menos no tengo carro, yo dependo de la CTA. ¿Vale? Entonces yo digo, si es de que cierren la clínica, ¿dónde voy a ir? Entonces yo pienso de que ese trauma o quizás esa depresión vuelvan otra vez a mí. Así como yo me siento mal, habemos muchos compañeros que estamos en las mismas condiciones, que necesitamos de esa ayuda de la clínica, porque para nosotros los enfermos pues es otro hogar.
I was suicidal when I joined the clinic, and they helped me so that I was able to overcome my suicidal tendencies and get a job and get a pension.
The clinics are so important. It keeps me stable. I was able to get my GED and go on to college. And now I'm about to graduate. I'm expecting to graduate in May. So without the clinic, I wouldn't be stable. I would be very unstable. I wouldn't be a good parent to my kids. I don't know where I would end up. I probably would end up, in jail or dead somewhere, right, if it weren't for the clinics. When you have a mental illness, you have to stay in a neighborhood where you're known it. Because if you go in other neighborhoods, people can attack you, or you can get paranoid, or something can happen, you know. That's just like me. If I go into another neighborhood and I'm not unknown to the people, not unknown to me, and I lose my mind there, you know, I would just be one person put in jail because, you know, it's best to have community. Each community needs their own mental health center.
Necesitamos el servicio de las clínicas mentales porque estamos establecidos y si nos las quitan, nos las cierran, seríamos un desastre en la calle y eso sería un desastre para el pueblo, para todos. Entonces, por favor, escúchenos, no cierre las clínicas, denos el servicio, ayúdenos porque lo necesitamos.
Well, the first time I went to the clinic, I had a plan to kill myself. Couldn't get any help, couldn't get any money. I was laying on the couch, unable to move a muscle. And an old friend of mine that I've known since I was 5, she called all over the city, finally found a place I could go. So it was right by my house. I took one bus up 111th Street. I think I cried the first 3 years there. Nobody looked at me funny. And I guess about 2 years ago, I gave up my suicide plan and decided to stay alive. Of course, I didn't know that Rahm Emanuel would decide I wasn't worth saving, but I have to say the clinic, they saved me.